Welcome to Red Carpet TV Nigeria. If this is your first time, kindly subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button below the video. For coverage of events, you can call any of the numbers in the description box. Thank you and enjoy our videos.
The sonorous voices of the choristers and high-profile guests at a well-organized Christian wake-up service at Ekiti on Friday, May 19, 2017, were just the perfect way to kickstart the jollities that followed the passage of a pillar and an icon. Was that of a man who lived a life of meritorious service to God, the nation, and humanity, and a man whose impact reverberated across all spheres of life, the late Major General Robert Adeyinka Adebayo, a patriot, a hero, and an icon. General Adebayo was a military governor of the Western Region. In July 1975, he retired from the Nigerian Army with the rank of a Major General. Even in retirement, his impact in the Nigerian society was largely felt as he remained passionately committed to the unity of the country. No doubt, the good general is gone, but his legacies of character, patriotism, and service to the people are forever indelible. General Adebayo's remarkable rites of passage began in Lagos on Wednesday, May 17, 2017, with a service of songs at the Haven Event Center, GRA, Ikeja. Sonorous voices of the Muslim choir unveiled the service as everyone crooned to the heavenly lyrics. Baba's son, Adedayo Adebayo, opened up the Bible reading with Psalms 39. His brother, Leke Adebayo, took the second Bible reading. This one paved way for the special rendition delivered by the Nigerian Army Band. Speaking on the topic, overcoming the vanities of this world, Right Reverend James Onishola Odedeji, the Bishop of the Diocese of Lagos West, dwelled on the wealth of the biblical Solomon, which was tantamount to vanity. Vote of thanks by Baba's daughter, Mrs. Nike Makinde, drew the curtain on the well-attended service. As it was on Wednesday, so it continued the next day, but this time with an uncommon spasm of sensation and streaming stroke of stimulation that spilled out from the Archbishop Binding Memorial Church Cathedral, GRA Ikeja. It was the commendation service and the last lap of farewell rites from Lagos. The pack of dignitaries at the church was unimaginable, and the emission of glory in and around the premises was unparalleled. It was all for a man who had made a difference in his generation, engraved his name in gold, and quit the stage when the ovation was loudest. Celestial songs rocked the cathedral like hurricane as Baba laid lifeless in a brown shiny casket. In his goodwill message, the governor of Lagos, Mr. Akinwumi Ambodi, spoke glowingly about Baba's greatness in life.
Yes, fine gentleman, elderly man, and perfect person. But the bottom line is, he had the love of the Yoruba race in his heart.
With the hallelujah song, the well-attended commendation service came to a close as Baba's casket was rolled out of the church. from Lagos to Ibadan, and finally to Ekiti, General Adebayo's funeral fiesta was filled with fanfare. But one of the prominent points of call was his home state capital, Ado-Ekiti, where a line in state and tributes was organized at the Oluyemi Kayode Stadium. Thousands of people of various interest groups thronged the stadium to honor the late general. The remains of Baba was driven into the venue amidst loud ovation. The Ekiti State Governor, Mr. Ayodele Fayoshi, in his speech, congratulated the children of Baba for having a father who was a national hero and a pride to the generality of Ekiti indigenes. With that, Baba's remains was then taken out of the stadium for a final homeward journey to his hometown in Ekiti. The wake-up service commenced later in the evening at the Adebayo Residential Estate in Ekiti. Sitting under the nice ambience were gorgeous guests, while the children of Baba looked immaculate in white apparels. The service was a mix of insightful biblical readings and delightful hymns. Again, tributes poured in.
Adeyinka Adebayo was a great man, a father figure. And throughout my military career, I had always remained connected to him. And then, of course, his beautiful family.
I feel so sad that we can no longer see him. But I thank God. And I thank you, Daddy, for your wonderful legacy, for the good name you've given us. It is more than money. You have given us the most wonderful future. You have given our children's children a name they'll be proud of.
The wake-up service came to a close with Thanksgiving. Obsequies continued the next day at the All Saints Anglican Church in Ekiti with a funeral service. In a flash, the entire pastoral community was locked up. The high-profile dignitaries had to make use of helicopters to facilitate easy movement. The casket of Baba was ushered into the confines of the House of God. While describing the late general as a disciplined and focused person whose love for humanity will forever remain grim, the Most Reverend Latunji Lashebikon submitted that death is an inevitable end.
If Jesus delays his coming, everybody here will die. There's no prevention against that. Death is a necessary end that will come when it will come.
In his ovation, acting president Professor Yemi Oshibajo posited that the late general Adebayo lived a life of service to his fatherland.
As indigenous chief of army staff, chairman of the Organization of African Unity Defense Planning Committee 1963 to 1965, first Nigerian army officer to attend the Imperial Defense College, where he was during the 1966 coup. Governor of Western Region, Commandant, Nigerian Defense Academy. His military trajectory was in a way was a study in Nigeria's history, even in return an inheritance for his children's children. The inheritance is not money or property. It's a legacy of character, of patriotism, of love of country, and service to the people. And we thank the Lord for the life and times of this good man, that the dark aspects of our nationhood might be illuminated by his unyielding search for peace and justice in our land. Nigeria has decided, in recognition of his service to Nigeria, to to rename the Federal University in Ekiti the Adeyinka Adebayo Rtd.
Paying their last respects to the general, who was an old boy of Christ's school at Ekiti. The school's alumni recited the school's anthem. And so, the service dragged on to the end when Baba's corpse was taken out of the church and driven along the rustic streets of Ekiti. Guests then converged on the large marquee in the Adebayo country home for a very lavish reception. The interior of the white marquee sports class and elegance. The soiree was no doubt an assemblage of the aristocratic class of the high society, courtesy of Baba's first son, Otumba Richard Adeni Adebayo, a commander of the Order of the Niger and first executive governor of Ekiti State. With King Sunny Ade on the bandstand, the party got really exciting with ceaseless flows of rhythmic vibes. All through the evening, guests enjoyed themselves to the fullest, especially with a continuous lounge of varieties of local and continental dishes. Cakes and cocktails were not left out as the excited guests helped themselves to the sweet paste. With his abundant delectations, which continued unabatedly till the very dark hours of the night, guests had no qualms joining some of Baba's children, who came upstage one after the other to dance. From the Red Carpet TV crew, we felicitate with the children of Baba, especially Otumba Niyi Adebayo, on the success of the burial of their patriarch, the late General Robert Adeyinka Adebayo.